Oh, you wanna know who else is tiny?
Who?
Vin Diesel.
Yeah, he is.
I didn't know how tall he was.
He's in a very compact package.
Yeah, like so, like I was talking to someone, and they're like, "Did you know that Vin Diesel's only 5'6"?" And I'm like, "Vin Diesel is the same height as me."
He's small but dense.
Also, apparently, they like change his voice when he's acting
really?
To make him sound different.
Oh wow, that's which, weird.
Yeah.
Come on, Vin Diesel. Step your game up.
Oh man, it'd be so weird to meet Vin Diesel.
Should we change our voices for this playthrough? Like make us sound like Vin Diesel?
Yeah. That'd be
hey
awesome.
Everybody, it's Vin Diesel and Vin Diesel. We're gonna play the Cat Lady.
The Cat Lady.
Which is probably a game he'd play.
Vin Diesel doesn't take me as a gamer.
Oh no, Vin Diesel's a huge gamer.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Vin Diesel is a lot like most of the people I know. He's super nerdy, he plays video games, and he's bi.
He's bi?
Yeah.
Ooh. I'm, like, getting more and more down with Vin Diesel by the day.
Yeah, no, Vin Diesel's actually pretty cool. He just also stars in shitty movies about cars. So we're playing the Cat Lady. if you hear clickety-clacks, that's my keyboard. Because this game is controlled with the keyboard for some unexplained reason. Let's go.
I'm excited. I really like this art style, even though you don't like this art style.
It's not the art style so much that bothers me. I think it's just the animation.
Okay.
My name is Susan Ashworth.
Hi, Susan. Mm-hmm.
I live alone in this old two-bedroom flat. I rarely go outside.
Sounds like a cat lady.
Yeah.
Oh, she's got a cat clock.
Yep.
I want a cat clock.
It works like a real cat, too, by getting in the way of things that you need.
Some would say it's a lonely life, and I guess that's true. But I don't like people's company. Not lately, anyway.
Not lately.
Okay.
She used to like people's company, but now she doesn't. Now she has staring contests with
her cats. I only trust my cats these days, and I will miss them dearly.
Aww.
But they will understand, like they always have. Teacup stays with me till the end.
Teacups.
He watches me as if he knew.
I like Teacup.
Not to be disrespectful, but I think Teacup's kind of a dumb name for a cat.
Why?
I don't know.
Because earlier tonight, I swallowed a whole bunch of pills.
Aw, poor Teacup.
They're legal, of course. Prescribed by my doctor for my sleeping
problems. Does she think we're gonna judge her if she was ODing on
I've taken
pills?
34 of them, all I could find in the cupboard. And now the room around me spins in a blurry tango as my heart slows down.
This type font kind of bothers me.
Yeah, a little bit. Also, this is definitely gonna be a weird game.
Well, yeah.
With an intro like this, you know you're in for a mind fuck.
I like Teacup.
That's Teacup's eyes.
Any second now,
for a minute there?
I will be dead. I feel calm. I'm ready for it.
Okay.
See, this is what it feels like to take one Ambien, though.
One
you're like, oh, here it comes. I've accepted death.
Oh, God.
Actually, that's what it feels like
okay,
to take
yeah,
two
Okay, yeah, this is
Ambien.
Definitely, like, freezing up every so often.
Oh.
This game is like, it was made with Adventure Game Studio, I think.
Thanks
and so
for
it's not
nothing.
Like, it's not coded specifically
Goodbye.
To be its own standalone thing. It was made with like a game creation studio that's available for you to like just download and use.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I think it's cool that people are making games too that are good enough that they can sell them
mm-hmm.
rather than just distribute them for free. But chapter...
Oh, wow, there's a lot of chapters.
I don't know. I don't think that's really an indication of how many there are. House in the Woods. Oh, that's such a good movie.
That's Cabin in the Woods.
Well, same difference. A cabin's a type of house, goddammit. Oh, look, the H is...
The moon.
The H is the moon.
The H is the moon.
It's the moon.
Going for some DreamWorks drama right there. Also, I thought that we were supposed to be in a forest. This looks like a field.
Yep, that's clearly a field. So. Okay, press left or right to walk. Let's go this way.
Okay, guess you can't go that way.
I just walked into an invisible wall. I guess that's the kind of thing that happens when you overdose on sleeping pills. It's very atmospheric.
I bet she's in a coma right now. I bet she didn't actually die.
Yeah.
Or this is supposed to be the whole, like your life flashing before your eyes, but it's all fucked up.
Press up to open the interaction menu, cycle through available options with up and down, and press enter to confirm. I feel strangely drawn. Oh, do you want to speak the dialogue for her, and I'll do any other characters?
Okay. I feel strangely drawn to this place. I must find a way to unlock this padlock and get inside. Why do you have to get inside?
I like that when you examine it, it's like, there's a padlock on it, but there's still an option to enter.
Yeah. It's locked.
Dang.
Bum bum. Keep on walking.
Let's keep on trucking.
Oh.
Keep on
still
rolling,
not in
baby.
A forest.
Yeah, no. I'm waiting for this forest to show up. It's broken Hot Wheels car back Mifty. There.
Mifty 37.
In a row? No pedestrian access?
We're in
Lady,
a tunnel.
You need to get in a car. This world doesn't have a whole lot in it.
No.
Oh.
Oh god, what the fuck was that?
Oh no.
Are those bugs? Oh, we're still in the...
Fuck you, Armachalskis. Okay, we know this.
Is this game gonna be just walking into things and looking at them?
Oops. Oh wait, let me do that again.
Ambulance.
Oh, this is buggy.
I can't go any further. This ambulance is blocking access to the tunnel exit. Oh, you're stuck in the tunnel. Maybe there's no exit at all. Oh man, this would suck if you were stuck here.
Wait,
Can you examine?
Oh, that's what I did.
Oh.
Open the door.
Let's see what's inside. It's fucking locked.
Oh, good. And I can't walk any further than this.
Okay, there must be something else you can examine. Unless this is literally still, like, the intro screen and they're just having us move around to jump scare us with titles.
Well, this is the only thing besides that door that I've seen that you can interact with.
Well, I guess we gotta walk back that way. Because there's probably gonna be something different. Those fucking weird, drippy spider things.
Oh.
Huh. Oh.
What's making that noise?
Are you
Hello?
Walking?
Who's there?
Oh, okay. This is cutscene
shit. Answer me!
Now it gives me control back. Thanks, game.
Weird. Guess they have to pay the voice actor. Whoa! Body. Look closer. It's me. Whoa. Okay. My cold dead body right in front of my eyes. What's it doing here?
What should we do? Examine, turn head, open eyes, open mouth, leave.
Open mouth. There's something in her mouth. The key's in her mouth.
Open tits.
The key's in her mouth.
Okay.
Told ya!
Jesus.
Is that a key in her mouth? In my mouth?
What the fuck?
I better take it with... There's always something in the mouth of a dead body.
What does that say again?
I'll better take it with me.
I guess I'll better. Press down to open inventory. Select item with left and right. Confirm with enter or press up to exit.
Can you go in the ambulance now that the door's open?
Maybe. But you know what? It would have been so much simpler to just code in mouse support for this.
Yeah.
Like, way simpler. Nope, can't go past.
Oh,
also,
okay.
Can't examine the body anymore. Once you open the mouth, you're done.
maybe we should have done other things other than open the mouth.
You're just too fucking good
you
at adventure games.
You probably just would have fucking... Yeah, I'm too good at adventure games. She probably just would have talked, like, fucking... poetic shit.
Oh, fuck. What the fuck?
Guess you can't go back there.
Game over. Okay.
Can you examine the rubble?
Can I?
No.
No. See, here's the thing. I've been playing adventure games since, like, the early 90s. Mm-hmm. And even I wasn't like, oh, the key's gonna be in her mouth.
What? Really?
Yeah. But you were like, open her mouth, the key's in her mouth.
I watch a lot of crime dramas.
Yeah, I guess. Oh.
Oh, hey!
Well, you know what? I've been playing adventure games since the early 90s, and I didn't think there would be a fucking deer here.
It looks like a gazelle.
It's a deer.
Oh, okay. It's a deer. Bye, deer.
Are we playing as the
oh,
deer now?
Oh, here's the forest.
What?
We found the forest.
Oh, boy.
Well, let's see what's in this
Dream
house.
Logic.
Key. Use.
Let's examine it.
Not long ago, even a key wouldn't open my mouth. Got some secrets. Now I find there was one inside of it.
Oh, this game's gonna be pretentious and artsy-fartsy.
Yeah, it is. Do we not have the key anymore? I guess we don't need the key anymore.
No. What's it?
The heartbeat.
Okay. Planks. I thought it said danks for a second.
Danks. A hole has been boarded up with these planks. We need to find out what's behind that hole. The sign underneath says emergency power switch danger. Bullet. Can we look through? There's definitely something there.
Looks like a switch.
It's a beating heart.
Pull.
I'm not strong enough to pull them off with my bare hands.
I think when we looked through, there was something else there, and I skipped it accidentally. Now she just looks at the wall. This game's programmed really weird.
Guess we'll keep moving.
Machine.
Too long a sacrifice can make a stone of the heart. Would it take another sacrifice to turn it back? Maybe I'm billing. Maybe I'm being silly. This is just some old machinery after all. Switch it on!
Yeah, fuck it.
How strange. There doesn't seem to be a single switch or button on this machine. How do you turn on? You literally put your heart inside of it.
Oops. Really?
Yeah.
Wait, what? But...
You can't walk past it?
No. Those are the only two things I can interact with.
Okay, so walk back out. The deer's probably back. We probably have to go find something in the woods to activate the machine. It's going to be the deer's heart. That's what it's going to be. We're going to have to kill the deer.
Oh, fuck.
How much you want to bet that happens?
Oh. This game's called The Cat Lady. I didn't think it was going to make us do, like, cruel things to animals.
No.
Oh, hi, dear.
He's definitely taking us somewhere. Oh, I think we're going to have to sacrifice the deer.
Yeah,
we're totally going to have to kill the deer.
Or the deer is going to, like, die in some other way. Or the deer was dead all along. This is one of those kind of games. That car was on fire. Fire. Okay. So...
Hanging body. I bet it's her again. My dead body hanging from a tree. I should be scared, but I just feel empty. Wait, what's that shiny thing on her neck? Is that a key? Oh, another key. This body, the body is too high. I can't reach.
Rope.
It would take really? Me hours to undo this knot.
You suck at knots. I'm sorry.
This rope is tied to a knot. Okay, right. I guess we're gonna go see what's in here. The door seems bolted from the other side.
Oh my god. This game is so frustrating. Oh my god.
You're just wandering around.
I can't remember this place. Am I lost?
Oh.
All right.
Okay. Let's examine it. What a gruesome display. I'm getting hungry. At least it's not my head stuck on the bars.
Getting hungry? Man, this makes me hungry for goat. Guess what? It's fucking locked.
It's locked.
Fuck you, game. This is walk back and forth and find more locked doors in the game. Oh, she was behind a tree. I bet she did the thing again.
Walk back and forth the game. For real.
Yeah. She keeps turning around, but I want to go this way. Oh, okay. Is this open now? Ugh. Nope. Still can't do anything here. The hell.
And introducing Walk Back and Forth, the game. Tired of mindlessly wandering through your house? Well, take a seat, because we have the game for you.
Where you can mindlessly wander through a weird dreamscape?
Yep.
Open the gate. No, you can't. It's locked. Sorry. Didn't mean to tease you like that. Actually, I did. Mean to tease you just like
there's
that.
There's something behind the tree? Can you, like, do anything behind this tree?
No. See, I thought maybe when she turns around and looks the other way, I should actually go that way.
Yeah. Like when the bird flies off in the opposite direction.
Well, like, she stops and then turns around. Maybe I should go back. Is this different in any way?
Yeah.
Is it a different scene?
Yeah. What the fuck?
Boy.
Man, I love Walk Back and Forth the game.
It's such a good non-game.
Okay, so I guess whenever the character turns, we just need to follow her lead.
Remember earlier when I said it's cool that people are using Adventure Game Studio to make games that are good enough to sell them?
Yeah.
What I meant was, man, it kind of sucks that people are cranking out games with Adventure Game Studio and thinking people will pay money for them.
Oh, cool. We can come back here.
Oh, good. Even though we didn't do anything that would... It's dark inside. And then when we enter, it's not actually all that dark.
Well, can we get the key back?
No, the key was just for that door. At least I would assume. Yeah, this is the same location, and we haven't gotten anything that would help us here.
Okay.
So
then I keep... guess we go that way.
Does this take us back to the garage? Yes, yeah. It does.
Maybe it'll let us look at the body. Oh, no, because there's a pile of rubble.
I guess it was a tunnel, not a garage.
No, because that pile of rubble's there.
Yeah, but maybe it's not, because this game's fucking weird. And I really shouldn't say that this game sucks and it's not worth paying for, but so far...
There needs to be some development fairly quickly to keep our interest. I bet we were supposed to do more shit with that body. God damn it. Damn me!
Well, no, because if we were supposed to do more shit with that body, it would let us. Like, unless this is just really poorly programmed. If it's like, if you look in her mouth first, you can't progress in the game. Mm. That's really bad. Okay, so walking to the left. Walking to the left.
Well, I guess we go back into the forest. And maybe if we turn around at a different time when the bird flies, it'll take us somewhere else.
Maybe. I kind of like this song.
Yeah.
I guess it's less of a song than, like, I kind of like this ambient music track.
A ditty.
It's a ditty. It's a little ditty.
Oh.
Oh, hi again, dear.
Hey, dear friend. Okay.
Okay.
Fucking hell.
There's the tree that crashed, the tree that crashed into a tree. The car that crashed into a tree and is on fire. There's the hanging body, the rope, and the door.
Can you open the door now?
I can try. Don't have high hopes. Nope, it's still bolted from the other side. This game was recommended to us on a forum post for like games that people who liked Sanitarium would like, because we were going to play Sanitarium and then we had video issues and couldn't record it. Mm. Wait. Now that the bird's flown, let's go back. Okay, following the bird now. Whoa. And she turned around.
Yeah.
So we'll go that way. Deer. Glitch through the deer. This is just going to take us back to that cabin shack thing. That's really weird. Oh, I get it.
Huh.
You are the deer.
Yeah. Where's the fucking bird?
There's the bird. Okay, so now we're at the gate. Mm-hmm. Which we can... Not open. Cool.
Why?
I don't know.
Okay, now turn around.
Now turn around and go back?
Yeah.
Nope.
No, keep going. See if anything changed.
Okay.
Okay. Now go back and do it when the second time the bird flies, try turning around.
Okay. Really? That didn't stop me that time.
Oh, it didn't stop you that time? But see, we're back at the deer.
Yeah, but this is just going to take us back to the cabin. Now.
Okay, well then...
Oh, God. Oh, it's so frustrating. You know what this means? We have to do this all over again. We have to walk all the way back over to the gate. Okay, we're at the gate. I'm going back. First time, it doesn't do anything if we turn around. Now, if we turn around, we're going to go back to the deer.
Uh-huh. Now, let's see where it takes us.
Okay. Deer.
Mm-hmm. Damn it.
All right, well, let's Let's do that whole sequence again.
Do you think I'm right?
What?
Do you think...
Think what?
Like, that's how it works.
What?
The bird.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm sure that's how it works.
But why can't we do it?
Because this game sucks. Like, I'm sure they had some good ideas with it, but they seem poorly implemented.
That'll take us back to the deer.
Okay. Oh, is the bird here?
Okay. There we go.
Now turn around. There's the bird. But...
Aha!
Okay, that was annoying.
Deer. Examine. You do have to cut apart the deer!
Oh yeah, totally.
Who's done this? Is there anyone else? You're gonna take the deer's heart and put it in the machine. Oh, you got a knife now. Do you have to cut out your own heart? No, you're gonna go get the key off your dead body. Because now we can cut down our body.
I should be careful with this thing.
Hit. Sharp. Good, you can cut through that fucking rope. It's a hunter's knife.
Oh. Wait, can I go this way at all?
Door.
There's a door.
Oh, that's the door that was...
I've got
from the
five
inside.
Bucks that says this is going to be locked, though.
Unbolted.
Oh, okay.
It's the door that was bolted from the inside.
You didn't accept the bet, so I don't have to pay you.
What?
It would take me hours to cut that.
Susan.
Press up to Susan.
Examine. I look like I'm just sleeping. Search pocket. Of course, nothing. Take key. From the Susan. Okay. Ooh, that took longer than necessary.
That took way longer than necessary. Something tells me this is going to be a relatively short game.
Yeah. Now I want to see how it ends.
Yeah.
Oh.
Unless it throws another bullshit puzzle like that at us.
Well, it didn't take us that long to...
Oh. Right.
Oh.
Hello.
Welcome to my house, Susan Ashworth.
Oh.
I have been waiting for you, my dear.
Get it, dear?
I knew you would turn up one fine day like this.
Who are you?
I have so many names, it's hard to pick one.
Could it be...
But I'm curious. Who do you think I am?
Satan? Death, an old lady who lives in the woods. Are you God? Are you the devil? I really don't know. Can't you just tell me? What do you think we should pick?
What was the first one?
Death.
An old lady that lives in the woods.
An old lady who lives in the woods?
Oh.
Am I really, Susan? Are you that naive?
Oh, jeez. Okay, what
bitch. Aren't you stubborn to see what I really am?
No, I don't know what you are.
I've waited all that time for you, and now you disappoint me.
Oh, shit, we disappointed this
skeleton. Wasted your time waiting. I'm not worth waiting for. I'm just nobody. And you, to me, you're just a strange old woman sitting on a porch of her house. Those flowers you're holding, what are they for anyway?
I'm going to put some on your coffin, dear. After everyone's gone.
I wouldn't bother. I hate flowers.
What is this place?
Yeah.
What is this place?
This, my dear, is my humble kingdom. And this house is my castle.
Are we in fucking purgatory?
I rarely invite people in, just like you. I like my solitude.
Oh, we got busted in this bitch's house.
But you are a special guest.
Oh, okay.
And I'm going to make an exception.
Me? Oh, is this the kingdom of the cat ladies?
God.
I can tell you now that there's nothing special about me, lady.
Spinsters Don't bring United. Yourself down, Susan Ashworth. Today, you are my guest of honor.
Oh.
What
will happen next?
Depends on you, Susan. Inside my house, there are dark hallways that lead to places you don't want to see. But there is also something that will make you want to return to where you came from and cherish every single little breath you take. I'm going to make you an offer, Susan. It's a chance only a fool would refuse.
Okay.
Are you the devil?
An offer? What can you offer me?
Let's come inside. It's getting cold out here.
But you're a skeleton lady.
It doesn't look cold. Can I play again?
Yeah. Oh. Painting. Look at.
A lonely seashore.
Touch it.
Please don't touch anything, dear.
I wasn't going to.
Yeah, totally
you lied
was going
to the
to.
Whole world, Susan. And you lied to yourself.
Oh, jeez.
Okay.
Wow. Strange lady.
Hi, strange lady.
Look at. Is she really here? Maybe this is all just a dream after all.
Now we can talk properly, my dear.
Is there anyone else here?
Is there anyone else here?
Hi. I thought you liked being alone.
Isn't
that why you ran away from everyone?
It doesn't matter.
I was standing right behind you when you threw away all those photographs, you know? I brushed your hair every night you cried yourself to sleep. I saw everything. I know what you want, but it's not here. It's gone, and it will never, ever come again.
Okay.
I still don't really know who you are.
I still don't really know who you are.
I go by many names. I've never paid much notice to what the living call me. But there is one name the fallen ones use when I speak to them. I find it most accurate. The Queen of Maggots.
Okay.
Is that what you are? Why maggots?
Because they feed on what's dead and gone.
Dead and gone. I guess that's me.
Will I be punished?
Will I be punished for taking my own life?
Most people would be, but not you, Susan.
Why am I so fucking special?
You see, I watched you long enough to understand how you feel. I don't expect you to believe me, but I actually have sympathy for you.
Oh, death has sympathy.
Who knows? I could be your only friend. The only friend in the whole wide world. So like I said, I'm going to make you an offer. I want to help you. I will give you back your happiness in exchange for a simple task. Your life will change completely. You will be yourself again. And you will soon forget the sadness that has consumed your heart for years.
Tell me why I want to live. I have no reason to live. Please just let me go. So you can be like, no.
You want me to pick that one?
Yeah.
I have no reason to live. Please, just...
be real pissed if the game's like, okay, bye.
I tried. I really did. But it's never going to be okay.
Who knows? Maybe. But one way or the other. This isn't the end of your story. It's only the beginning, my dear.
Oh my gosh.
A great thing.
If I killed myself
for you
and I came to this, I'd be like, come on!
Believe me.
Yeah.
I just wanted to fucking die!
And the only person you run into is like, hey, I need you to do something for me. Really? Really? I thought I was done with this shit.
Fine, I guess. What do you want me to do?
What do you want me to do?
Yes. I think it's time
to explain. Oh, now it's time to explain? Mm-hmm. Fuck you, Skeleton Lady.
But where are my manners? We're still in the hall. This is not a place for a serious talk. Follow me to the next room. I'll tell you everything you need to know.
Should I touch the painting?
Yes, touch the painting.
Oh, won't let me. Aw, fuck you, game.
What's your offer, then? What can you fix that life has destroyed?
Susan, death can fix nothing. But though we are both dead, I am not death. I might seem just like a strange old woman to you, but I'm just as powerful as gods. And I chose you, Susan Ashworth. I need you to go back and face five people. They're not ordinary people. They're very special. Just like you. Only in a slightly different way.
Just like you, only different.
You have to be a Reaper now?
Well, that's not what she said.
But... Well... Basically, what I'm getting from this is now we have to go convince five people to not to kill themselves.
Okay.
I'm a failure. Why did you choose me? Aren't you afraid I will let you down? Whatever it is I have to do. Most days, it's enough of a struggle to crawl out of bed. I don't see the point in anything. I just want to disappear. And I hate everyone else because they know how to be happy. Everywhere I turn, there are people filled with hope and will to live. Or people so pitiful, they make me ashamed to be alive. I don't want them. There's nobody there for me. I am alone. I just want to vanish.
So dramatic.
This is the very reason I chose you, Susan Ashworth. I know how you feel, because I felt like this myself for a very long time. You and me are very much alike. If you succeed, you will never feel broken again.
Who are these people?
Those five people, who are they?
The parasites, that's what I call them. They don't know each other, but their destinies are bound together. You will have to keep your eyes open and be constantly on guard. Those people will want to get closer to you. They might even pretend they are your friends, but don't let that fool you. They have nothing but cruel intentions. They'll want to hurt you, Susan. They'll want to kill you.
Okay.
As harmless as they might appear, parasites are the evil scum of the earth, and they all deserve to die.
Isn't my life bad enough without them?
Don't be frightened. You will have a great advantage over them. They don't know that you know. Do you understand?
Teacup has to come back.
What it means? You will become my hunter, serving punishment for their sins.
Oh!
A tool of destruction. A dark angel walking through the river of blood. You find your purpose in life and you see for the first time how satisfying it can be.
But how will I recognize them?
There isn't a great deal of people in your lonely life, is there, Susan? You will know when you see them. Bring those deceitful bastards in front of me, and we'll make them regret for everything they've done.
Okay.
Ooh. Something tells me we're only gonna get to ask one of these. Which one should we ask?
Are you expecting me to kill them?
Are you expecting me to kill them?
No, Susan, I'm expecting you to fight for survival. To do everything you can to defend yourself. I know you're not a murderer. Quite the opposite, actually. You're a good person. But I also know that you don't want to suffer. And those people will want to cause you pain. They won't hesitate. In the end, you might have no choice. Think of it as gardening. If there were weeds among the flowers, you'd pull them out, wouldn't you? You'd get rid of them without thinking twice about it.
I'm not really a gardening type, but I see your point.
I'm glad.
Do you?
And remember this, you are not the only victim. If you don't stop them, the killing will continue. Innocent people will die. You have the opportunity to make the difference.
The difference.
And chance to save yourself.
Okay. All right. So, she knows we don't want to suffer. Mm-hmm. And so she's sending us to face people who want to harm us.
Uh-huh.
She also doesn't expect us to kill them. She expects us to fight for survival, even though we just killed ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
She has really whacked expectations. Like, I expect you to fight for survival, suicidal person.
Well, something had to drive her to suicide. I feel like she's probably gonna, like, confront abusers and shit.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we're gonna find out what drove her to where she got to, but... I don't know. The logic here seems to be falling apart. Makes you think
what makes
go back?
You think I want to go back?
Because you don't have a choice.
I finally did it. I killed myself. That's all I ever wanted. And yet, it turns out to be just another failure.
Yeah, like I said, I'd be really pissed if I killed myself and ended up here.
Yeah.
Dear Susan, you don't realize that the suffering never stops.
Oh!
Do you?
Bleak.
It only gets worse.
What?
This place is a passage between the world of the living and the world of the
dead. I told you we're in purgatory.
You enter one of these corridors and you never come back. But you don't cease to exist. You remain.
I can't do this. It's too much. Dealing with criminals is a job for the police, not someone
they're
like
not
me.
They're criminals, they're just better, bad people.
Indeed, you are.
She said that if we don't stop them, the killing will continue.
That's
and
why
people
I
will
have
die,
prepared
though.
A special gift for you.
People can drive people to kill themselves.
Immortality.
What?
You cannot die, Susan. You will always return to life, no matter what happens to you.
Oh.
What? This is the last thing I wanted. Please, can't you just let me die?
This is your own personal hell.
I've made the decision. As long as they are alive, you cannot die.
Okay. It's blackmail.
God.
It's blackmail. You can't do that.
I'm doing it for your own good. Anyway, you are in no position to bargain with me. Because you will either go and do what you have to do, or suffer for eternity. Forever unable to find your peace.
What a bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Should I just say the same thing over and over again?
This all must be just a weird dream. I don't believe you.
Susan, see this door here?
No.
Let's go inside.
My head just kind of disappeared.
I want to show you something that will help you make up your mind. Follow me.
What about that fucking machine that we couldn't turn on?
Yeah.
Are we gonna have to play the entire goddamn game before we turn on that fucking machine?
There might not even be any way to turn that machine on. This is that kind of game, I think.
Say hello.
I don't want to look at it. Haven't I had enough yet? That body in the ambulance. Then the forest. But this place is... This is exactly what I was trying to run away from. I don't want to be here. Make it go away.
I assumed it would be wise to give you a little taste of the suffering you'd endure. I want you to understand that you can keep going long after you count.
Crucified. All alone, the one place that changed it all.
What?
I really don't
want to
be here.
I really don't want to be here. Death? She already said that she's not dead. Like, we know that she's not.
It's time to make a decision. The parasites are coming, whether you want it or not. You haven't really got much choice. You must stand up for yourself.
I'll do it my way.
I take orders from nobody. I'll do it my way.
Don't you understand? There is no other way.
Well, I don't know that. Besides,
you
could be lying to me. How do I know you aren't? I'm no murderer. I don't want to be. I'll find another way without you.
What?
Look, I appreciate you giving me another chance.
No, you don't.
Don't get me wrong. I can see now that I've made a mistake, and I'm ready to try to fix my life. But I really don't like what you're saying. If there's one thing I learned in life, it's that people let you down all the time. If I don't rely on myself, I can't rely on anyone else.
You fool! You damned arrogant fool! You have no idea what you have just done!
If we have to start over the game, I'm gonna be really pissed.
If we have to start over the game, I'm
but
done.
Fine. Have it your way. In the end, I will be the one laughing at you. I always am.
Be sarcastic!
Should I be sarcastic?
At this point?
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't laugh too hard, old woman. You might break something.
When we meet again, you will beg me on your knees to give you a second chance.
I don't really believe in second chances, so I might have to disappoint you again. Look, this is all just a bad dream. I want to wake up. I'm back in the house.
Oh, candle.
Okay, it'll be fine.
Okay.
I don't need her. I'm sure I'll figure out what to do.
Okay.
Strange. The flame seems strong and steady, but there is no smoke.
Blow out all the candles. I don't feel
they
like
left me no choice, Alice.
You're not really playing the game.
Maybe one
We're
day
just watching a
you'll
short
forgive
film.
Me.
Yeah. So that guy killed himself.
What? Okay, so I guess when we blow out the candles, we kill people?
I think that's enough for now.
And I turned invisible. Alright.
I think that's enough for now.
Oh, could I have blown out other candles and had other people kill themselves?
I guess. We'll never know.
No, still can't touch the painting.
We just pissed off. Bitch face.
What the? How did I get back here?
Good question. Can't go that way. Oh boy. Oh. You wanna look at the body?
Yeah, might as well.
No, I'm still nothing there. Fuck it.
I guess we gotta go make friends with the deer.
I think the deer's dead.
Is that the same deer? Nope, he's... There.
Still glitching through him. Still can't do anything with him.
I like the music.
Oh, we can use the crowbar to take the boards off the wall.
Yep.
Nice. The music got really dramatic.
Yeah. It's like shit going down music.
Hmm.
It's a pretty sky.
Yeah.
I really like the colors. Textures are good too.
Yeah.
Enter.
Alright, so now we can finally come over here. We can use the crowbar.
Hole. Examine the hole. The sirenity says emergency power switch danger. It's dark inside. All this blood around the hole, was someone hurt here?
We didn't notice that before?
No.
Alright.
The... it was covering... Ah!
Okay. Alright, we got our arm cut off.
You have to make a sacrifice to turn on the machine.
No, we can't do anything.
I don't know where you had to get her arm cut off.
We're just... still can't do anything with the machine. I thought something was gonna happen. Wow. Okay, this is not how you do credits.
Is this what happens when you're a dick to death?
But she wasn't death.
No. squishy sounds. What the fuck?
The cat lady, everybody.
What?
The cat lady.
What? What?
Pictures of things. The cat lady.
What? What would have happened if we were like, fine, we'll do your shit?
I guess we'll never find out, because I'm not playing through that again.
Well, I'm going to have to play through it, because I want to know. I don't like it when games do that, though.
No.
When you, like...
Wait.
God damn it! God damn... What the fuck? What?!
Do you want to keep playing this?
Well, I'm intrigued
yes,
now.
I do enjoy fine art.
I'm angry, though.
Thank you for noticing. There's a certain raw beauty to it that modern painters often fail to recreate. I always wanted to be an artist myself, but it'll be a long time before I can call myself that. I often say that patrons are my canvas. But my job is more about restoration, obviously. I look at the damaged human minds and bring them back to their former beauty.
It's not a really healthy way to look at
sorry,
Dr. Payton's
I'm sorry, I'm probably boring you.
No, it's not that.
Just that I
it's
came back from the dead and had my arm cut off.
It's been a difficult couple of days. I'd really like to go home.
Of course, and go home you will. As soon as we've done this little assessment, okay, you probably know how it works. I've read in your file you used to be a nurse.
Yes, I know very well how it works. You want to check if I'm nuts?
Well, I wouldn't use that expression, obviously.
Damaged,
but
though.
Yes, we have to make sure you're safe and figure out how to help you. Also, as a nurse yourself, you know there's always paperwork involved. These forms won't fill themselves. Honestly, Susan, you have nothing to worry about.
This dude's really
this
creepy.
This is just a formality.
Really
I could tell straight away that you are not nuts.
I love nuts.
Fine. What would you like to know? I will answer
peanuts,
all your questions.
Cashews,
then I'll go home,
macadamia.
Take a long shower, and catch up on sleep.
Wonderful. Let's see then. Where do we begin?
Okay, so she said she's going to answer all of his questions. Are we going to have to sit here and answer questions?
She's awake, Doctor.
Good evening. It's good to see you awake at last. You're in the Cedar Lake Hospital. My name is Andrew. I'm one of the doctors. Would you confirm your name for me, please?
I'm going to pick the last option and have her just be like, ignore. I can't remember. I mean, clearly we can remember because we have these options.
Yeah. Ignore.
Ignore.
I can see you're very tired and sleepy. It's perfectly normal. You're on the ward now. Your condition is stable. Earlier on, we did a CT scan and it shows there's no permanent damage to your brain. All your organs are fine too.
Oh.
You're a very lucky lady, Susan. You might experience extreme tiredness and lethargy for a couple of days, but that should soon pass. I would advise plenty of rest now. The nurses on this ward will take it from here. Please, let them know if you need anything. Take care, Susan. Yeah? Please, don't try to speak.
Even though I just asked you to
What
try
did you
to
say?
Speak.
Don't worry, Mrs. Ashworth. Your arm is fine.
What?
No, no, no. There was nothing wrong with your arm, darling. Now calm down.
Would you like me to get you some water? Let me get you a drink. I'll be back in a second.
Okay, so you live alone. You don't have any friends.
Mm-hmm.
You take 30-something sleeping pills.
Mm-hmm.
How do you number one, live through that. And number two, end up in the hospital with no brain or organ damage.
It happens.
Does it? Because who found me?
Teacup called 911.
Ah, gotcha.
I'm sorry, Susan. Did I wake you? I have to take your blood pressure. 2 seconds and I'm gone. My name is Liz, by the way. Hi.
Hi.
I'm sorry. Hi. I know this isn't very nice. Believe me, I hate waking people up just for this. But being a nuisance is part of my stupid job, unfortunately.
Wow.
Oof, I hate this place. Tell you what, Susan. Can I call you Susan? So anyway, I shouldn't say it, but you know I'm going to anyway. You are so lucky. It's crazy. You, doing what you've done, and her, walking in, seeing what she saw. That was a chance. 1 in 1,000,000.
Okay.
I'm not making any sense again, am I?
Old lady.
I'm tired. They're working us to death here, you know. Modern day slavery. One day I'll tell them what I really think. I swear I will. Ah, and here it is. You've got the blood pressure of an 18-year-old. Just wanted to say you're lucky, I think. And that I hope you've changed your mind about some things. Got to go, but I'll see you later. You take care, sweetheart, yeah?
Bye. The Queen saved her.
The Queen of Maggots.
Yep.
Oh, music budget ran out.
What? God damn it. Whoa.
Cool.
The cat lady. And you're like, the fuck?
Well, that was an interesting chapter.
Bad dream.
I don't know if anybody else noticed this, but it's been 10:09 the whole time.
Yep. They ran out of animation budget for the clock.
Should I ignore her?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
You don't want to talk about it.
I don't want to talk at all.
I understand. Sometimes it's easier not to talk. To keep it to yourself. I feel like that here sometimes. A lot, actually. As soon as you open your mouth, you realize that nobody listens. They might pretend they do. But you can tell by the eyes. Eyes will always give you away. My nan used to say that. The thing is, I don't care anymore. I'm just playing a game now. Like everyone else. Just playing a game.
Ignore?
Yeah.
You're a quiet type, aren't you?
Yeah, we're going to do the strong silence.
But you're
going
to have to talk sooner or later. I hope you realize. They will ask you questions, you know? Now, it's not my intention to scare you, but that's what they do. And you know that. They can't let you go if they believe you will try it again. This place is under a suicide watch. If you're not careful,
the
they'll get you
a room with
padded walls and no view. You really don't want that, trust me.
Does it really matter if you're actually nuts,
Look,
though?
I'm only trying to help you.
No, apparently if you just want to answer their questions, they
lock
you up.
A way to avoid all this. I could give you a hand.
What?
I could help you go home. It's up to you.
I don't trust her.
Tell you what, if you don't want to talk, you don't have to. I came here to hide and rest my legs for 2 minutes. Oh, it's 2 in the morning.
No, it's not.
I'm really tired. I hate this place. Everyone keeps ignoring me. You might as well do the same. Maybe there is something wrong with me after all. Maybe I talk too much.
Yeah.
Do I talk too much, Susan? Just tell me and I will shut up. I'm just very lonely, I guess. I know you probably don't care. Why would you? You must have enough problems of your own. You wouldn't be here otherwise, would you? But I just wish... Never mind. I really do want to help, you know. There are some people here who aren't that nice. I see it all the time. They'll do what they can to set you and lock you up. You don't want to end up in a nut house, do you? I can tell you're not that sort of person. I can tell you're all right.
Losing interest. Time.
That's all.
Oh, it's going to force me to talk to her now.
Nope.
No, yeah. Nope. I've lost interest in this game.
Yeah, me. So. I might come back to it.
You think so?
Yeah, I might.
Well, in any case, thank you all for taking this weird-ass
thanks for watching journey this with movie us. Game with us.
Yeah. Thanks for watching us play walk back and forth and occasionally interact with something the game.
And we were afraid there was going to be too much keyboard clicking. I wish we had to punch more keys.
Yeah. Yeah. See, the thing about games is, if you can't play them, they're not interesting.
No.
This barely would qualify as, like, an interactive novel.
Yeah. This is a choose-your-own-adventure with a video.
It's not, though. Because you can't even really make your own choices. Except for the whole thing where we could have been like, maybe we could have been like, okay, I'll do what you tell me, and it might have ended up being different.
I feel like we still had to chop off our arm no matter what.
Probably, yeah.
So, I don't know how that could have... So we got to be snarky.
Yeah, we got to be snarky. You get to choose your own dialogue in the story that's set out for you very rigidly, because I wanted to ignore this bitch, and now it's like, nope, you don't have that option anymore.
Nope. Now you gotta talk.
Yeah. So, okay. Maybe Casey will come back to this game at some point.
Maybe. Well, yeah. I really like the art style. And sure. As far as, like, games go, it's approachable for me. Because I'm not super coordinated. And I do kind of want to find out what happens. But at this point, at this time of night, I'm just done. Like, this is stupid. Why does this exist?
This time of night being 10:09.
I had a long day.
No, it's actually 11 o'clock p.m. right now, but
oh.
I was making a joke.
Oh, well, I didn't know. I thought...
The completely static clock on the wall.
I thought it was actually 10 o'clock.
It probably would have been better to just not have the clock on the wall, because then it's really obvious that you
but
didn't
then,
do
but
anything.
But you're in a hospital. There's always a clock.
Yeah, it could have been on a different wall. What? Where do they put the clock, like, right next
I
to a window?
I bet 10:09 is going to come in handy later in this game.
Or I doubt it.
Or all the clocks are going to be set to 10:09.
Maybe. I don't care enough to find out.
Not right now.
Basically, what I'm thinking is... If you want to play an adventure game, which is an approachable kind of game for you because it doesn't require coordination.
There needs to be adventure.
Well, there needs to be adventure. There needs to be something for you to do. There's way better examples out there. Mm. Two of which I just downloaded recently, so...
Okay. Get my adventure game on.
Yeah, we'll get our adventure game on, but possibly not anymore of this one.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
We've waffled long enough. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.